Children, welcome to a new class of English language. Today in this class we are going to learn about nouns. So children, you know what a noun is? A noun is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. Now do you know that there are many kind of nouns? Now let's see what we have in this chapter. Now here is a small table given, and we have to differentiate all these words in different columns and color them. So take out your colors and let's do this fun game. Now here are some words in this column. Let's see all these words. The first we have is the word water. So water is an uncountable noun. Why uncountable? Because water is liquid and it cannot be converted into a plural form. And it cannot be counted also. So water is an uncountable noun. You can color this box with any color. Then we have the word Aditya. It is a proper noun because it's the name of a specific person. Then we have the word children. Children is a common noun. So color this box with a different color. We have the word Greece. It is the name of a country and it is to be placed in this column under the proper nouns. Then we have the word furniture. So children, you can count these furnitures. 1, 2, 3, 4. And it is to be placed under this column of countable nouns. Lastly, we have the word sympathy. Children, sympathy means sahanubhuti. So, can you see it? No, you can only feel it. So, those nouns which cannot be seen and can only be felt are termed under abstract noun. So this is done, and color all this box with different colors. Let's move on and see what all these different kinds of nouns are. First we have the common noun. What is a common noun? Common nouns are names of classes of people, place, animals, things, etc. Like students, teachers, and there are some more examples like boys, girls, chair, table. These are all common nouns which show the names of the same class. Then we have the next noun, proper noun, which says that it is the name of specific people, place, animal, things. Like Ruskin Bond, Missouri, and Lucknow, Kanpur, America, New York. These are all proper nouns. Then we have concrete. Now, some nouns can be touched and felt by our five senses. That is eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. So those nouns are concrete nouns. So let's see what the definition says. Definition says that nouns that can be experienced by the five senses. Example is friends, world and many more like this. Then we have the abstract noun. Now as I said before, we have segregated sympathy in the column abstract noun. Now the word sympathy can only be felt and cannot be touched or experienced by our five senses. So all those nouns that refer to emotions, ideas, qualities, etc. are termed under abstract nouns. For example, love, wealth and many more like this. Next we have the collective noun. Now let's see what a collective noun is. It is the names for collection of specific nouns of the same kind. So the collection of specific nouns of same kind are termed under collective nouns, like troop of actors, school of fish, clutch of eggs. These words are collective nouns. Now children, let's do an exercise. Here we have the names of some common nouns, and in this column we have the collective nouns for them. Let's do it. Now, the first we have is the deer. So, for deer, we have herd of deer. Then we have people. So, the collective noun for people is crowd, which is here. So, for people, the collective noun is crowd. Then we have guards. The collective noun for it is deck. For collective noun for flowers is bouquet. Ships, it is fleet. Students. Now, let's see where this answer is. For students, we have class of students. So, for students, we'll mention here class of students. Then we have the word dancers. So, dancers is, what do we have the collective noun? It is troop of dancers. So, this is mentioned here 7. Then we have robbers. For robbers, the collective noun is gang of robbers. For stairs, we have the flight of stairs. And lastly, the last word we have is books. And for books, the collective noun we use is library. So this is all. And let's see what we have next. Now in this question, here are some group of proper nouns given, and we have to write the common nouns here. Now let's see what do we have to write for the first question. The first question we have is names like Cuttack, Karachi, London, Venice. So, what are these? They are the names of city. So, we'll write the common term city for all these group of proper nouns. Next is Brazil, Egypt, Bangladesh, Japan. So, these are names of country. So, it is country. C-O-U-N-T-R-Y, country. Then we have the names Dickens, Bond, Carol, Rowling. They are authors or writers. So you can write here A-U-T-H-O-R, author. Then we have the proper names Rajdhani, Shatabdi, Toronto, Tejas. So these are names of trains. We'll write train over here. Then we have Ganguly, Dravid, Dhoni, Kohli. So, they are the cricketers. So, we'll write here cricketers. I hope you have understood this much. So, we'll do it for now, and we'll meet in a next class with the rest of the chapter. Hope you loved it, enjoyed it. Bye-bye.